Okay, gonna share my screen right now. All right, so as I said that, I know that this Friday is gonna be day off for you. So some of you may would like to spend some time for play a game or whatever. So the last lab is the lab number 10, right? And the lab number 9, and today the lab number 10, I'm gonna set the due date of both lab to be next Friday. So you're gonna have 2 weeks for this lab. So yeah, you're gonna have more time to doing, you have more time to rest. Okay, let's talk about the lab. As teacher said that she didn't tell you about the linked list that much, but some of our lab, actually half of our lab are involving with the linked list. So if you can't do it, it's fine. Just after teacher have teaching you about the linked list, you just come back to doing or solve this lab.
But next Monday, I will teach about the linked list. Okay.
Yeah. Yes. So yeah, it's fine. So if you can't do the lab today, so it's fine. Okay, let's talk about the first lab. The lab 10-1 is the get the. So teacher taught you about the stack, right? So this one is actually nearly the same the same question in the exam that I tell you that, okay, I give you the total number of students. I give the score that they get from the midterm, final, and the homeworks. And I add that you get the names. And then you tell me back that, okay, each student what the score they get, the grade they got, and also you order by the score. So it means that, okay, Mr. A got 20, 20, 15, so he technically, oh, I'm sorry, it should be 40, 40, 15. Okay, so he should be get a 95 score, right? Mr. A got 95 score and he got A grade. Mr. B have 31, 19, 20. So it means that he got 70 score and he got B grade. And Mr. C, he got 40, 40, 20. Also, it means that he got one full score, 100 score, and he got A grade. And you output me back the each student, order by their score, and give me back that grade. All right. For the next test case, I give you 4 people, the posse, Yama, Tela, TT, and they score. So you give me back, okay, TT got 79 score with B grade, and the rest got 0 score, and they got F. You have to order by their score, but if they got exactly same score, you order by the input. So, Posu, Yama, Tela, you're gonna order the same, Posu, Yama, Tela, okay? This one is not that hard, I guess. You can do the same way that you did in the final, in the midterm exam, but this time I ask you to using stack. So technically, I'm gonna hint you that you create a stack about they collecting a student name, collecting their score, and then have that grade. And then you compute all the stack and then just output the stack. All right. The second one, the income is nearly the same. You I give you the worker information, and then you give me back what the salary of the income of that worker. So you got the first, you got how many worker you're gonna have, and each worker consists of 3 data. The first one is their name, Mr. A, and second one is their salary. This is 300 baht per month, and the last one is they're working or not. So NNYYY is mean that, okay, he have to work 5 days, but actually he come to work only 3 days. Yes, it mean that he working. No, it mean he absent. So technically you have to compute that, okay, he have 5 days to work, but he only come work for 3 days. So it mean that he got only T over 5 from his 300 salary. So it mean that he gonna get only 180 baht. For Mr. A, for Mr. B, he got 1,000 salary and he come all state. So he never absent. So he got all his salary. So Mr. B got 1,000 baht. And Mr. C, he have 200 baht, sorry, but he never come. He only have one day for work, but he never come. So it means that Mr. C gonna get 0 baht. Something like that. You just tell me that, okay, I give you a name, I give your salary, I give how many working day he have to work and how many day he come and how many day he absence. You compute me the income they should get deduct by the day that they don't come. Right, just that. I also give you the formula to calculate, but it's just a proportion of the day he come over the day he had to come. Right. For you also have to using stack to solve this answer. The question. So these two questions are used only stack that you learn in the class, but the layer use linked list. And if you don't know about linked list, it's fine. It's fine. So after teacher have taught you, you're gonna do it back when teacher taught. Or if you would like to know about yourself, you can using the internet to study about the linked list is. But actually, it's just a type of stack that involving with the pointer is not hard for coding, but it's a little hard to understand. But okay, that's fine. And also, I think that all you guys would like to do a work that really, really simple, because some of you guys told me that, okay, the last week is really hard. So, okay, I give you really simple work that I'm gonna bring the last five questions that we already did in the past lab or past exam, and I just bring it back and ask you to using linked list and stack to solve it. So this is the last one in circle. If you remember that I give you the total people in the circle and I ask them to count the number. For this question, I ask them that, okay, we have five people in the circle and ask two, mean that, okay, every person count number two gonna leave the circle. It's gonna be a game that, okay, people count one and two, okay, two leave, then start one again and count two leave again and give me back the last people or the winner. So it's the same question that we did in the lab number eight. But what I ask you is that you have to use linked list to solve it. So basically, you can use the same algorithm that you make, just adapt it to use linked list. Okay, not that hard if you can solve the last lab question. Sorry, the lab number eight question. Next is the palindrome. The same as you did, I give you the palindrome. You check me, is a palindrome or not, but you have to use linked list. And I give you a hint that tied to you by directional linked list if you can, and I give you the website to understand what is the linked list or bidirectional linked list to learn by yourself that what is bidirectional linked list is. But if you don't would like to use bidirectional linked list, it's fine. But I think it's a good knowledge to study by on your own, because when you're going to a second year or when you go to the final project when you are senior, you can use this a lot. Okay, just output me is a palindrome or not, but you have to use linked list. The fifth question is reverse order, the same in the lab that I give you a list. I tell you how many numbers you're gonna get. I give you a layer in order, but you have to use linked list to solve it. So technically the same algorithm, but try to adapt, not using for loop that you always use, but use linked list instance. Right. And for the number six, move zero, if you still remember, I give you the array of input that consists of a lot of number, but they have a lot of zero in that, and you have to move zero to the back. That every person did, but this time I ask you to use linked list to solve it. And the last one is sort 0, 1, 2. The same last lab that we did. That okay, I give you number a lot of list. A number that I tell you at first that how many number you're gonna get. I give you all the number only 0, 1, 2. You're gonna sort the number for me, but this time you have to sort using the linked list. So yeah, technically is that every question that you did in the question number 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 are all the questions that you have done before. It will be in the lab number 7, number 8, number 9, or in the exam. You can use the period algorithm that you create to answer the lab or in the exam and adapt it using the linked list to answer all the questions they have. So it will be not that hard work. You just gonna study about what linked list is. Okay, that's all. Have you guys have any question? Sorry about I say something confused. It's too morning for me. Normally I wake up noon. Right, anyone have any question? Oh. Yeah. All right, I think no one have any question because this lab is very simple. It's just the last lab that you have done all by yourself, but I just ask you to adapt using linked list. And for any people who don't understand linked list, it's fine. It's fine. After teacher have taught you, you just come back and do this lab. And all the lab number 9 and number 10, I'm gonna set the due date to be next Friday. So you can, you're gonna have a plenty time to working with it. And if you feel that it's too short for you, you're gonna need more time, you can contact me so I can adapt the due date, because all of you, some of you may not know what linked list is. It may be hard for you. So it's very simple. I give you a plenty of time, but if you feel stuck over it, you can contact me. I can extend the due date or whatever. But if you have any question, you can contact me in live chat as usual. So thank you for today. That is.
Thank you very much, Anon. Mm-hmm. So before I forget about how to